local park, but I'm just been trying a different area. Doing a wee bit around the edge of the rail and digging a heap of pull tabs. Had one 10 cent coin so far and just had a good coin signal. Very wet soil. I do believe this is an old point. Old half penny by the look of it. Let's see if I can get a date off in there. Hang on. ...1915. So that's a good find. Good too, because I was getting disheartened with all the pull tabs and bottle lids. That's a good coin. Carry on. I'm going to do this area here and then I'm going to pop out and do some of that field. So you can spot the coin and just push the top of the dirt off with the pinpointer. That's the colour I like. 1991 New Zealand $2 coin. Good stuff. New Zealand dollar. This is a classic example of why you should dig all signals. This here was saying S cap, which we're all tempted to not dig. And look what's just popped out from an inch under the ground. Doesn't appear to have any markings on it. It's probably junk, but it's still a very cool find. I'm actually out on the field now, so I've only just started. I found a couple of 2 cent pieces straight away. I'll keep going and see what else we can turn up. More stuff like that. Cool. Under the spectator's eyes. Just unearthed another old coin out here. I'm still out on the sports field. It's just popped up. New Zealand penny. 1947. I think I have a few of that year, so there must be quite a few of them around. Just had another coin signal. I've been getting a heap of 1s and 2 cent coins. I'm just going down the sideline now and turns out this is a star badge, which is star is a rugby team from Timaru, sort of a city that's nearby. Being an extra Tamuka rugby player, we actually call them star bastards, but that's a whole different story. But yeah, that's a cool wee find. Just thinking about saying that all the ones and twos I'm digging are a good 5 to 6 inches deep, so I'll be lucky to get many old coins and lo and behold, look what just popped out of the hole. It's British. Oh, I tell a lie. It's a New Zealand sixpence, 1936. That's a good looking coin. Yeah, I won't rub it too much. I'll give it a good clean when I get home. But first silver for the day. Good stuff. Obviously found a bit of a coin spill here because you can probably see the outline, but here's one plug, there's another plug, and then underneath the knife with another coin. We'll dig it up and see what it is. Spill of some sort. I found 1 cent there, 1 cent there, 2 cent under here, and another 1 cent. That's the imprint. So quite a few little coins. Another hole, another good coin. New Zealand half penny, it's 1946. It's out here in front of the stadium, so there used to be an old stadium here. I'm expecting that maybe there was lots of gatherings for ceremonies and things, so hopefully we get onto a few more of these. It's had another signal. Dug a 1 cent piece out of this plug, and then right beside it had a high pitched tone, which I thought was a 2 cent coin, and we've just dug another 1936 sixpence. That's the second one for today, same year. Looks like some pretty good nick too. That's good stuff. It's still daylight, so we'll carry on. I just managed to dig this out of the ground. Presumably it's lead. It's heavy like lead. It's got a funny texture to it though. Looks like a handle of something, cool. If anyone else out there has seen something similar, then you might know what it's been broken off.
Well, here's cool. My grand total of everything at the end of the day. It's been a rather successful day down on that rugby field. I've only covered sort of one part of the sideline and managed to turn up all this, so can't wait to get back down there. Yeah, just a few old corns there, twos and ones, lots of them. Got a couple of gold corns, so that was cool, something to spend. The real the winners for the day were the two silvers. They're both 1936, as you can see there. Nice, reasonably nice condition. Can't get too close with this camera because it doesn't have a very good close-up zoom. And then, yeah, a couple of half pennies. New Zealand penny. And this here, I think, is a spent bullet. But I'm not too sure. I've compared it with nail heads and things I've got, and it doesn't look like anything diameter-wise like that, so it's actually very close to the front diameter, or behind the mushed bit, to the infield bullet that Mark sent down to me, so it could be something like that, I don't know. The wee star rugby football club badge, as I said earlier on, bloody star bastards. But it's still a cool find. That club's no more. That club and the Zingaree local club amalgamated to be, they're called the Harlequins. But yeah, I got this wee bit of jewellery as well. Big heavy bit of glass in it. This thing here, I don't really know what the heck it is. It's quite silverish here, I scratched it. Don't think it's lead though. It's got a funny patina on it and it's real smooth. But who knows. And just some assorted old sprigs from games of past. So yeah, all in all, that was a pretty good day out. And we'll see you next time.